11 News reporter Kim Dacey is live in Annapolis. She has details for us. Kim?
Well, Rod, with more state budget cuts, as you mentioned, on the horizon, and now that we're well into July, it's a good time to take a look at the state economy and see just how we're doing so far this year. And that checkup took place tonight in Annapolis. The economy isn't doing so well, but Maryland is doing better than most states. That was the crux of a gathering in Annapolis Tuesday night.
Marylanders haven't felt the pinch as much as other states around the country, but when they look at their statements, their account values are down.
So event organizers invited former Governor Bob Ehrlich to assess the situation. Ehrlich says much of the problem is overspending and problems with the special session of the General Assembly.
The problem here is in 2007, we saw this looming recession. We knew that revenue would be a problem. We knew there would be shortfalls, and yet additional dollars were spent, and then a special session came around, and then additional dollars in order to pass the slots bill were generated.
Ehrlich wouldn't comment on Governor Martin O'Malley's proposed $280 million budget cuts, except to say it needs to be done since we ended last fiscal year with a deficit. He also sees bigger problems at the end of 2010 when federal stimulus money runs out. He calls that money a Band-Aid.
There's a bad lesson here. It's you don't overspend on the eve of recession. You don't raise taxes, particularly regressive taxes, on the eve of recession. And you don't use stimulus dollars to paper over recurring expenditures, because once those dollars stop, you're going to have a gigantic budget hole.
Financial experts say the economy on the national scale could still dip once again before things turn around for good. Reporting live in Annapolis, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.
And for more details on the governor's budget plan or the planned budget cuts, you can go to our website, WBALTV.com, and then click on Project Economy.